A very good morning to all the students of class 11 to the online classes of political science. Students, today we shall be starting our ninth part. We had already finished our eight parts, and in that we had finished our fundamental duties of the Indian citizens, which are given in the constitution, and also we had understood the topic directive principles of the state policy. So today we shall be taking the topic philosophy of the constitution. That is, we shall try to understand what do we understand by the philosophy of the constitution in terms of India or any constitution. But mostly we shall be referring to India and the, all the important elements related to the constitution in relation to philosophy to India. So first of all, when I begin a particular topic, I would like to, and I always tell you the meaning of the important terms coming within that unit or particular topic. So here the meaning is philosophy of constitution. But before I move forward, let me tell you, as according to the revised syllabus, as you must have checked your new revised syllabus, your syllabus has been cut down because of this COVID-19. So many of the chapters have been removed and many topics have been merged with the other chapters. So this topic, if I talk about this topic, this was the chapter number 10 of your book, that is philosophy of the constitution. It was a whole individual chapter, but now this topic, philosophy of the constitution, has been merged with chapter 1, that is constitution. So now we will not be going in detail about this particular topic. We will just try and understand what does philosophy of constitution mean in relation to the constitution of India. Okay, so meaning of philosophy. So we will take the meaning of philosophy. I have taken a definition for you here. A theory or attitude that acts as a guiding principle for behavior. So what we can say, this philosophy, you can see it is the guidelines or some of the rules or laws, or we can say behavior according to which a constitution runs. So for example, it's written here, don't expect anything and you won't be disappointed. That's my philosophy in life. So in personal terms, if I say, suppose I'm talking about myself, I don't expect anything from anyone, not my parents, not my friends, not my neighbors. I'm not expecting anything from anyone. It means I won't be disappointed. For example, on my birthday, I'm expecting an expensive gift from my parents. But at the end of the day, I wait for the whole day on my birthday, but I don't get that particular expensive gift for which I was waiting. So at the end of the day on my birthday, I shall be disappointed. And the reason why I'm disappointed is because I expected something from my parents or from my friends. So what's my philosophy? If I don't expect, so I don't expect anything, you won't be disappointed. So this is my life style of my life, or these are the values of my life which I follow. Everyone has a different behavior, different approach towards life. So if I say this is my philosophy in life, that I don't expect anything from anyone, and so I'm never disappointed because I don't expect. So these so what is my guideline? So I can say this is my guideline. I don't expect anything from anyone. So this is my guideline. So I can also say this is my philosophy in life. So as a human being, you must also be having many qualities, or these qualities that according to which you can say that this is my philosophy. Or you can say I have given you some assignment, and you are always successful and you always get good marks. You make a very good assignments every time. So I will ask you, how can you do it? So what you will say? Hard work. So that hard work is your philosophy in life. You say, sir or ma'am, hard work is the philosophy of my life. So whatever assignments or whatever targets, objectives, aims are there for me to achieve, I always do hard work. So that hard work is your guiding force, it's a guiding principle or the philosophy of your life. In the same way, there are certain guidelines or philosophy or objectives or aims according to which constitution works. So philosophy of constitution. So we will try and understand what is the philosophy of constitution, what are those guidelines, those principles according to which the laws, provisions and articles are run in our country. So I would like to take one more definition for you. Another definition for the philosophy, just the meaning of philosophy. Meaning: the study of the fundamental nature of knowledge, reality, existence, especially when considered as an academic discipline. So we are here studying political science as an academic discipline, and our topic is philosophy of constitution. So this is our academic discipline. So in relation to philosophy of constitution as an academic discipline, we are trying to study what are the fundamental nature of constitution or knowledge we want to get about the constitution, what is the reality on which constitution has been framed, or existence, how it is existing, as we have done in the previous parts also, how it came into existence, how the idea of constitution came into being. All this we have already done. So under philosophy of constitution, we try to understand the fundamental nature of knowledge, reality, existence, especially when considered as an academic discipline. Now moving forward with this particular topic, philosophy of constitution, now we're starting the subject matter. What is the exact we have to study in this? We have to understand the meaning, okay, and the concept of philosophy of constitution. So it's written here, the first point: all law do not have moral content. All law do not have a moral content, but most of laws have moral values embedded in them. They are saying, whenever there are laws, what are laws? First of all, what do we understand by laws? Whenever we make laws, first of all, we focus on the society, the type of people, the rules and regulations, and the guiding forces to balance and bring equality in the society. What of society? What type of government we are having? What type of political system we are following? All these are the, we can say, guiding principles to form different rules and regulations or laws in a particular place. So all laws, we can say, do not have moral content, but most of laws have moral values embedded in them. Example: right to opportunity of work, right against discrimination, etc. They are saying every law which are made in by the constitution or by the authority, it is having some or the other moral values attached or embedded within it. So if I say right to opportunity or right against discrimination, if I say there should be not be discrimination against people on the basis of their religion, caste, language, it means it is connected to our laws, or sorry, it is related to somewhere to our moral values. That is, we believe on equality in a society. We have faith on that there should be equality between human beings, and there should not be discrimination on the basis of religion, caste, language, etc. As we all are humans, so we should be equal. It means there is a moral value of equality, and we all have faith and trust on this equality. So these rules and laws which were made, right to opportunity, right against discrimination, these were made under equality. So equality was a force run under these moral values. So we can say all laws do not have moral content. Which laws we can say do not have moral content, but some laws will not have moral content or the moral values. For example, we can say we are appointing a president, or we are having the election for the chief justice of we can say Supreme Court or the High Court. Okay, so these will be some of the rules and regulations which do not have moral content. But if we talk about right to opportunity, right to equality, and the right against discrimination, right, fundamental rights we are talking about, all those have somewhere moral values which run them. Thus, we can say that there exists connection between laws and moral values. So by the topic which we have done above this, so by that I want to explain that there always is a connection between the laws which are made in the society and the moral values, because those laws somewhere are having the moral values, because the laws are made according to the society. The needs and demands and aspirations of the citizens of a society are fulfilled and also controlled their activities with the help of laws, and those laws are mostly connected to the moral values of the people. Thus, we need to adopt political philosophy approach. So we need to have political philosophy approach to constitution. So if I say what type of a philosophy a constitution should follow, so it should follow our approach, it should be political philosophy, because under political philosophy there will be a, we can say, connection between laws and moral values, because it is very important for us to know the laws which we are making for the people, it must be attached to the moral values of society, because without the moral values it would be harsh as a law to be implemented on the people. So the policy we should have is political philosophy approach of constitution. So we'll try and understand what do we understand by political philosophy approach to constitution. What does political philosophy mean? So to understand political philosophy, we shall be understanding three important elements to understand the complete meaning of political philosophy approach to constitution and why it is important. As we have done up this topic, that it is there is always a connection between the law and the moral values, and this is the approach, political philosophical approach to constitution, and there are three important elements which we shall be understanding. And the first is under political philosophy, that means understand conceptual structure of constitution. That means conceptual structure means all the important concepts which are read and we have already read under constitution. That is, understand meaning of terms used in the constitution. That is, we have to understand complete meaning and the concept which are coming in the constitution, such as what is the meaning of rights, secular, democratic or secularism, citizenship, democracy, republic. We have to understand their meaning, and we also have to relate their concept, that why they came into being, why they are used in the constitution. Okay, so this is the first one. Second important element of the political philosophy of the constitution is that better grasp of set of ideals. There are always set of ideals in the constitution or mentioned in the constitution by the founding fathers of the constitution. There were basic ideals, important ideals, to understand key concepts of the constitution, to understand the important concepts which we have discussed, democracy, secularism, citizenship, rights, fundamental rights, etc. To understand all these concepts, it is very important to grasp the set of ideals. Set of ideals also we can relate to why these ideas came into being, how they were implemented, how they were, as there were different opinions, how they came to a satisfactory result, that these should be the concepts included in the constitution. So, and the third is, a philosophical treatment of value is incomplete if detailed justification of it is not provided. They are saying, if we are talking about some moral values along with the laws, on a connection between the laws and the moral values, it shall be incomplete. That concept shall be incomplete if there is no justification given or provided. It means they were saying, in the past also, in the Constituent Assembly, there was a participation of the people from all sections of the society. All the religion, all the caste, maybe rich, poor, everyone. Okay, so there was always some debates over some particular concept or some provision or some article. So they were, the one who was giving that particular provision always had to justify in case to have a proper understanding of that particular concept. So they are saying here, philosophical treatment, if we have to give a philosophical treatment, philosophy meaning I have already told you, a fundamental understanding of a particular concept, it is very important to have a detailed justification of it is provided. Thus interpret constitution with reference to Constituent Assembly debates. Now the next is philosophy of our constitution. What do we understand by the philosophy of our constitution? We have already done, but it's written what are the important elements which we have to include here. Philosophy of our constitution is committed to freedom. These, whenever a question will be there for the philosophy of the constitution, along with the definitions and the three important elements of the political philosophy of the constitution, we have to add, for philosophy of constitution is committed to freedom, equality, social justice and some form of national unity. So as we know, in the day-to-day life, as you saw, always there are debates in relation to different norms, rules, regulations or new laws coming up related to freedom of the people, equality or discrimination, all related to equality, social justice. If we talk about reservations, giving reservations to deprived social classes or all the classes or the communities which are lagging behind, that's for social justice. It is discussed in everyday life now. and a form of national unity. But underneath all this, okay, promoting freedom, equality, social justice, along with the national unity, we also have to always keep in mind and be focused that along with this, there is clear emphasis on peaceful. Our country basic structure is we should be peaceful and democratic measures for putting this philosophy into practice. We have to put this philosophy, we have to bring freedom, equality, social justice, national unity. But in that way, we should not imbalance or disturb the peace and decorum and democratic measures of our country.